Hello, and welcome back to Good Brews, Bad Views. I'm your host, Max, and as always, joined by Ryan and James.
Howdy.
Yo.
And this week, we are watching Deep Rising, which I will, of course, call Deep Horizon at least once before the end of this recording. So, this was the first movie we've watched that I have not seen beforehand, and you guys have both watched this before, right?
Yeah, I saw this one in the theater, actually, and it stuck with me. It's a movie from 1998, and it's got some genuinely funny parts in it, but also some really cool sci-fi monster-y things that it's kind of stuck with me over the years, so I'm glad we're doing it.
Yeah, and I'm sure we'll get into that in depth as we're watching that movie.
Truth.
So, James, what about you? Did you see this in the theater as well, or...
I can't remember, but I know that Ryan and I probably watched this like four or five times
in high school.
Because we
hands down.
We enjoyed this movie from a it's a bad movie perspective. So I think this hits a sweet spot for what we like to watch.
Okay. All right. Good.
Absolutely.
So I think all three of us today have done what we refer to as the Thorpe method, which is watching the movie a scant number of hours. Oh, no.
Ironically, I watched it yesterday.
Yeah, James is the only one who's prepared this week.
So, Brian and I both watched this movie earlier today. So, we'll have the joy of watching this twice in one day, I suppose. So,
joy's in quotation marks there.
Yes. Joy.
Quotation joy.
Quotations and italics. Nice. All right, so if you're watching along, we have the movie queued up just as Hollywood Pictures displays below the Sphinx on the opening titles. So,
hey, what are you drinking, Max?
Oh, I am drinking Cranium Crush by Petosky Brewing Company, a Michigan brew, aptly chosen because of a cranium that does get crushed in this movie.
Deep cut.
Yes. Well, not really.
Shallow. Superficial cuts.
Well, I mean, what about you guys?
I am consuming today the Torpedo Extra IPA from Sierra Nevada Brewing Company. It's
good choice, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have Sin Eater from Dragonmead, which is another actually very local brewing company to us.
Yep.
And it's pretty much because everybody gets eaten.
Yes.
Also, I think this beer has like 12% alcohol in
something
it.
Something like that. 11
if I
12.
Become more and more incoherent, I promise it's not the movie.
Excellent.
Just partially the movie. So, ready? All right, here we go.
Roll that beautiful bean footage.
I thought this was like an Earthbound soundtrack just when it started opening.
You know, honestly, that's one of my biggest issues with the movie is I think the soundtrack is way cheesier than the movie is.
Yeah.
I could see that. This is also one of the first like two or three separate expositions in this movie to try to justify why this monster exists.
Right.
Yeah.
So you can trust these to be real facts because it's shown as text, barren text, before the beginning of the film.
Just like Blade Runner.
Right. Yeah. And Hollywood is basically a visual textbook of global history, so trust it.
Yeah.
There you go.
As opposed to Hollywood novels.
Right.
It's interesting to me that the movie opens up with such horrible CGI, or not even CGI, just horrible effects.
Right.
Because I actually think that the CGI in this movie holds up pretty well
for the most part.
Only when there's not a lot of it being shown on the screen because they can take more care to render everything.
Right.
Yeah, I mean that's there, but this is 1950s level horror movie.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll give you that.
And the CGI and good portions of this movie isn't noticeably bad.
Right. It suffers from what a lot of movies did with CGI in kind of this era.
Yeah.
Is the rendering and texture work is fairly solid, but the lighting isn't correct.
Yeah.
Like
there's really only one scene where I particularly was like, okay, that's some terrible CGI, and I'll bring it up when it comes up.
Right.
And here we have the boat with fake rain.
Right.
Yep. Again, with the bad opening.
I'm wondering if anyone on the internet has ever, like, audited movies to come up with a ratio of interior shots of vehicles that do and do not include a dancing hula doll. Because it's like,
oh, wow.
It's like 100%
of
all of them include a dancing hula doll.
I thought his seat was a repurposed proton pack from Ghostbusters.
This movie's really proud of the windshield wiper blades that go across the whole window.
Like every possible chance to use them, they're used.
Yeah. Okay, so the first thing I noticed about this movie is that the main character sounds like he was dubbed over
yeah.
the entire time.
Yeah.
It never sounds like he's actually saying what he's saying.
He's one of my favorite just secondary characters ever is Pantucci. Because this guy's the perfect combo of a hilarious voice, but like he's really into the acting.
Yeah. Plus, he kind of looks like someone took William H. Macy, Kurt Russell, and middle-aged Harrison Ford, stuck them into a blender, and
out pops Treat Williams.
Yeah, and out pops Treat Williams. Yeah.
And Sagat just showed up.
Yeah.
Yep.
It looks like Sagat is shaking Treat's chair.
Yeah.
I wouldn't put it past them. Did you notice that line went right through an island?
Yeah, actually.
Yeah. See, he would have gone further, but his screen ended there.
Right. Oh.
Ah, yes. 1980s. A good year for wine.
Right. So begins one of the issues with this movie when it comes to the dialogue. It's like they just wrote in all of the cliched jokes and were meaning to replace them at a later time.
Or add in non-jokes?
Yeah. I hope he actually has that sign, by the way.
Yeah, right. like he pointed to it.
Yeah,
we'll
have to be a little more eagle-eyed to see, because that'd be great.
Well, you picked out that hula doll, in the background.
That's why they paid me the big bucks.
I'm surprised that deck-mounted gun never actually comes into play.
That when I first rewatched this, I was like, hey, why are there two boats? Because
yeah,
that transition's really,
really
awkward.
Yeah. Transition. So Treat Weird. Williams won this role over his lesser famous cousin, Snack McElroy.
The exterior of this boat actually never looks terrible when they keep cutting away to it.
That is the worst, which is right here with the zoom
in
shot.
Yeah.
But everywhere else looks pretty all right.
So we go to this interior casino, and part of me thinks that we just transition to the 1920s, just because of how decadent and stereotypically quote unquote Asian everything looks.
Right.
The music transition here is really odd too, from the lounge lizard to suddenly
Sinatra-esque, but not quite.
Yeah, but then it transfers right over immediately to banging Japanese drum music out of the middle of nowhere.
The taiko drumming.
And when that scene starts up, the guy in the leftmost part of the frame, it looks like a fat Italian guy with a fake mustache drumming away.
Oh gosh, the guy, the bushy mustache guy who was betting right there. He needs to win all that money so he can get himself a nice comb. Bushiest mustache. Tom Selleck would be jealous.
So, are we only hearing one of the types of music that's being played? Because all these people are dancing and doing stuff to, beats that have nothing to do with what's going on screen.
Right.
There you go.
You just don't get it, James. Yeah. Now, the guy on the left here, wait for it.
He's into that drumming.
He's just some guy with a mustache.
Yeah.
He looks like he wants to be against the ninja.
Right. Yeah, he does.
Be against your ninja.
Is this glass on?
Yeah. Good thing the entire ship can hear that. No.
Captain Atherton. Of all the names for them to pick. And that, too. That's a terrible name for a boat.
Not okay.
Titanic 2 did not go well.
apparently, in
polls.
So I guess one of the main lessons of this movie is to never take the maiden voyage of the most luxurious ship.
Oh no,
in the world.
No, gosh, no.
Between this and Titanic.
You want to go on the second voyage
after
the maiden voyage receives rave reviews.
Yeah.
And does not wind up at the bottom of the ocean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why is reception in the middle of the ship?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
You want them on the hull?
Yeah.
Underwater? Scuba gear?
Scuba gear reception.
Yeah. With the band set up right in front of the taiko drummers right in front of them.
it looks like there's far more staff than actual guests on this right. ship.
Well, he does talk about how he fucked up the math later on, so maybe that was his problem.
Yeah.
We have 4,000 employees and we only have 200 rooms.
Do we need all 50 fire twirlers right. and the dragon right there?
Do you only need fire on a boat?
Well, you're surrounded by water. You're
banister ornaments look like ice cream cones.
This is what happens when you star in a or play as a villain in a 1990s James Bond movie. You have a fate rested to be Jean Grey and female leads in cheesy action movies.
Why does he have gloves on?
Because he's fancy. He's the captain.
Yeah, but it's creepy.
The Navy itself is kind of creepy.
It is the last aristocracy in the United States.
Mm. Oh, really? Champagne. You're the only one I ever need for yeah. my life.
Champagne. Champagne. So this shot here, when she hears something, this is actually one of my deepest fears, is this exact situation. To be on a boat in a large body of water and just hear something horrifying.
Yeah. This is what your characters heard in the Delta Green game we were playing last night.
Yeah,
that weird sounds.
This shot is awful. Like that.
Oh gosh, yeah.
Bad. That was she was just in front of a Windows like 95 screensaver is what that looked like.
Hey, I like
less
that.
Definition. I said less definition.
If you watch the transition there, the rain effect doesn't change between shots. Yeah. The background just changes.
So that's Jaimon Hansuo, or however the hell you say it. He actually auditioned for the role of Drax in Guardians and lost it to,
Really?
Dave Bautista. That's right.
Oh, look at you with actual facts for this.
Yeah.
Right?
Someone did some actual research.
The Australian guy, I double-checked, he played Kano in the first Mortal Kombat. That's Trevor Goddard, and he died a couple years ago from, I think, a drug overdose.
Oh, okay.
In real life.
Yeah. Accurate casting, considering Kano is an Australian character in Mortal Kombat.
That first Mortal Kombat movie is actually pretty good.
It's pretty good. I like it a lot.
Yeah,
the second one was dismal.
I'll give you this. Like, this movie has a pretty diverse cast for the pirate crew.
Yeah.
Hatchet. But, all they're missing is, like, a Eastern European guy.
Right. And the British dude, he was in frickin' Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels and Snatch.
Oh, yeah.
But,
yeah, he was, isn't he?
At the time of this recording, I haven't actually seen either of those movies.
You haven't seen those movies?
Mm-mm.
Oh, wow.
Both great movies. Both also on Netflix, I believe. I thought that was Seal at first.
I believe I can fly. This is so mean.
I get the vibe that these guys have been together for a long time.
Yeah, they're a close-knit crew.
But at the same time, they act later in the movie as a completely untrained bunch of buffoons.
Oh,
yes.
Right.
Lots of there'll be a lot of gun fondling coming up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean you're right. They show the bonds of spending time at combat, but they're not terribly disciplined.
No. No.
This kind of picks to what Max and I were kind of talking about a little bit earlier before we started recording too. That scene right there reminds me in some ways of the opening scene of Aliens when they're showing all of the
Marines.
The Colonial Marines
busting each other's chops.
Yeah, getting at it and everything and going at each other and having fun.
I love this guy.
I think this movie takes a lot of cues from Aliens specifically.
Yeah,
sure.
Yeah.
Well, Pantucci's kind of the Bill Paxton, they're coming out of the goddamn walls guy at times,
Yeah.
Whatever, Corporal Hicks.
Yeah.
You just add that to the list of people he looks like.
Yeah. <Ba-na-na-na>.
I like that it's just in a case.
Yeah.
Because are they going to pick that up and put it somewhere?
Yeah, they got the torpedo launcher.
Do you know how heavy a torpedo is?
No, I don't. I'm not in the Navy.
Hundreds and hundreds of pounds, if not thousands.
Don't worry about it, James.
Yeah.
Keep your disbelief suspended.
Yeah.
The guy from Africa does have very large muscles and is a growing boy, I suppose.
Yeah, right.
Mr. Jaimon is, he is in shape.
Speaking of.
You know, there was talk of a God of War movie years ago, and that's the guy they wanted to play Kratos was Jaimon.
Hmm.
Yeah. Dave Jaffe himself.
I'm assuming the internet would have taken that very well.
Yeah.
Kicking. I hear kicking sounds.
How are those? How are their chairs shaking? Sagat's not up here rumbling.
Yeah, I know. He's not up here to move them around.
Her accent has changed, / dropped, / she is no longer as Asian as she was. I'm surprised this spear gun never comes into play again.
Yeah, it's like this is the only scene.
And it's still loaded?
Yeah.
He's just fast, Max.
He's a minute man.
Yeah. You didn't ask anything.
Good job, Apo.
I thought we put him inside a box and then put
it's
that
a ship-tatership.
Mail that box to myself. I hate that guy's face so much. The Middle Eastern British dude, or where the hell he is.
Indian
British dude. Yeah, your face, buddy.
Yeah.
Guns.
Yeah.
Might as well have just one gun.
This whole sequence is just really odd.
Yeah.
Establishing dominance.
Yeah. Also, that gun looks absolutely tiny in that guy's hand.
Oh, yeah.
In the Australian's hand?
Yeah.
Got big old man hands.
Yeah, he was a good Kano.
Yeah, I really do enjoy that first Mortal Kombat movie. Bring it, internet.
Yeah.
Oh, thank God my pants are already brown.
Somebody brought his brown pants.
He put points in lockpicking.
Classic. Yeah. That was 7 easy. Seconds. That's all it takes.
Apparently, this boat is owned by Legendary Pictures.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No one will notice that.
It's Big League Chew, probably.
Paid big bucks to have them be the gum that was used.
So, do you think that's a recording, or that's some lady on a side of a...
I believe it's a recording that the name is key to the user card.
Yeah, but that's
plus what
fun.
They allude to. Yeah, I know. Some light blinks.
This
in the
is one of the cheapest
somewhere.
Looking sets in the entire movie.
Yeah, you know what? I didn't notice that before, but I will completely agree with you.
No, you're right.
It looks like a gym
else,
locker room.
That also has a tiny briefcase.
Wow. That was already open. She didn't have to cook it up.
Yeah.
The Red Bandit, yeah.
That jacket doesn't fit him at all, either. No. Captain Atherton.
No.
Facts.
Did you see that it says jail division on her mugshot?
I don't suppose that's just arithmetic for inmates.
Not good enough to be wanted in 5.
Right. Just under.
I hope that these are crewmen that exists for the sole purpose of people who break into the vault.
All yeah. Right. Vault division.
Vault division, yeah. And those epaulettes are way too big for his jacket, too.
Right. I wonder if they
just ordered
a
jacket that's way too small
away.
For him.
Wee. Throw her in the brunch brig.
Yay, brunch. Dude, she gets the sweetest deal out of all.
I know,
all
yeah.
Are those
food that
drums
shows up later?
In the back right there? What are those?
Jars of, I think they're...
It's fancy food, James. You wouldn't understand.
I guess.
Well, I can see that the rope is around there that they would, if they would stack them next to each other, they wouldn't break. Which is why they put those fancy netting around bottles of liquor sometimes.
Yeah, yeah.
But obviously not his head. Let me power up my proton pack.
More with the cliched lines.
Right.
He's just generic.
I
want to
punch him in the
hero.
Face so much.
Who, Treat?
No, Joey.
I love Joey.
Did this come out of nowhere to the rest of you guys, too?
That they were a couple?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I actually appreciated that, though.
Yeah. It gives his character some, like,
a little bit of depth.
And, yeah, something he was, you know, striving for.
Yeah. You know, a common ground between them. I mean, they're both, they're grease monkeys. They're mechanic types.
Yeah.
No, I, like, none of that. I just, it meant, like, they didn't really
get right,
into
right.
it
There's
at
no
all.
Lead into
There's
it.
No lead
it's
into
like...
it.
Yeah, well, they, other than him being nosy
yeah, right.
and her, like, complaining about stuff outside, they really haven't had any screen time up until now.
It just looks yeah. like a garbage disposal. Big Trouble. If you haven't seen that movie, watch it immediately.
Yeah, it's a good movie. You would never do that.
No. You wouldn't. No.
And just side note, these guns are fucking awesome looking. I think they're amazing. I mean, the design is just not great as far as being useful, I don't think.
Yeah,
but,
watertight auto-cooling guns.
Yeah.
But they look awesome, it, I think.
It seems like those guns, they filmed this movie after giving them guns that were just look cool, and then people complained that they weren't, like, those guns wouldn't work, it's not water. They would fill in water and, like, this and that. And so they just kind of made up everything as they
right.
they added that scene in.
All right, so now we see some 90s-esque computer use.
I've had enough of these lame tunes on the ship. Let's party with some Lou Bega, some Spin Doctors, some underwater ocean sounds to make passengers think that we have a pot of whales escorting the ship.
They spared no expense.
Right. That. Mamba number five, here I come.
So did you guys figure out or correctly guess who this was doing this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, obviously, there's only been a couple people yeah. on the ship who've been introduced.
Just like at all.
Yeah.
So as the systems start going offline here, the image that immediately pops into my head is, nuh-uh-uh, you didn't say the magic words.
Also, later on, he makes reference to the fact that by doing this...
They hacked the Gibson!
Yeah. By doing this, he destroyed all of the internal systems and, quote,
no one knows how computer works in the 90s.
Well, but hold on, melted their cores? But when he throws the disks back into the briefcase...
They're all broken.
So,
yeah.
Like, that seems like an unnecessary step.
Well, he hacked through the blackest of ice and uploaded some fatal Chinese military virus and just destroyed the systems.
That's nonsense. Storms don't happen.
Hey, there's those windshield wipers again.
Yeah.
Which apparently are not affected by the computer glitches.
No, they're manual.
They're manual.
You got guys in the galley just pulling them back and forth.
Or the big wheel has like,
yep.
has like a blinker on it.
Okay, so another Hollywood cliche here.
It's big, and there's forward lighting off the computer. The
no,
screen's so bright.
Right, right.
The ergonomics would be ridiculous.
So, can no one else read the depth numbers? Does he have to read each increment aloud?
And I'm surprised it's not in fathoms.
Right.
You know.
It is the Navy. They always do, like, repeat and say things for each other, and at least that's what Hollywood's taught me.
Right. Like I said, they're just...
And that looks bad.
Factual. Yeah, it's pretty bad. This scene is cool, though. The whole crash scene.
Yeah.
Could you imagine being a set dresser for this?
Yeah, because you know they had to try to get this in one take, because this is just chaos.
Yeah, that's about it.
Yeah.
Do you think the monster ate that bird that was in that cage?
Well, yeah. That's probably the first thing it went for. That's the whole reason it's there.
Ah, fruit!
No! I wasn't ready for dessert. Plot device.
Yeah. Oh, I missed that.
Yeah.
I fell on the strawberries.
I've been jammed. Running is hard.
Yeah, this is just Jesus. This movie actually is a lot more brutal at times than I remember, too.
This is another...
This was, like, forecast as soon as she sat down.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. This means that the boat must have piping directly...
to the ocean.
Unless, I mean, it... Because, like, theoretically, it shouldn't have busted through anything, really.
Unless it... That's where it came in, through the boat...
That comes in directly
into the septic system.
I also am fairly certain that same shot of that same section of ceiling is used every time anyone looks at the ceiling in this movie.
Okay.
So remember how that looked. And that... Oh, boy.
So here we see the first person killed by the monster.
Right.
And that, this folks... movie does a very, very good job of not showing it of what the monster is, or just showing pieces of it throughout the film, right. Which...
So that last
good
bit
job.
There.
Good job on that.
That's why you don't have coffee and Chipotle in the same meal.
Ooh.
That's also another cool, like, brutal scene, like you said right there. Because, I mean, the implication there is that they're...
Death by prolapse.
No, it's pulling her through the toilet, and that's
but
why
beginning
she exploded.
With prolapse.
Yeah, at the beginning.
You know, interestingly, he starts, you know, being mad when they're punching the bolts in or whatever, but did he just stare at them while they were walking and hauling all this shit on the front of this boat and not say anything?
I'm just going to zip tie it to the railing.
But I'm going to charge you a whole lot more extra bison bucks to finish this now.
See, Sagat used all those bison bucks to replace his lost eye.
Yeah.
You get hair plugs.
There you go. Wes Studi. Study. I don't know how you say it.
Oh no!
They had a boat made of gasoline and bullets.
Yeah, no shit. Why? You know, I took some notes here and I went to type running over a dinghy, but I typed running over a gingy, which is way funnier.
Who named? She's not getting any petrol. Don't fool us and make us think you're British.
Right.
That chair is way too cool for this movie.
I know. Right. Like, I want that chair. Like, we're sitting in some pretty nice chairs right now, and I kind of want that chair, even though it's probably not comfortable at all.
You know, a shot in about 20 seconds ago, the surfboard was on the outside. I didn't notice that before. That's actually a plot point at the end of the movie.
Yeah, I was at the end, I'm like, why is there a surfboard?
And you'll actually catch a brief
glimpse of
it
later. The way he's handling those torpedoes is a little...
Yeah, it's a little...
Yeah.
There's some phallic enjoyment going on there a little bit. Yeah.
I like how he says, got me, even though he had night vision goggles on and clearly saw what they hit.
Yes. Right.
It was algae.
He's a real boy.
I've got no props to make me go.
No, not because no one else can fix the engines.
Yeah.
Maybe you don't know what that means.
Stop necking. Oh, the chair. There's speakers on that chair. Zoom.
It's not a speaker.
Enhance. Enhance again.
Enhance. A bunch of strange men with torpedoes on a boat? Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
It's raining mercenaries. This guy is such a shit actor. He's so bad.
But he's one of the few Native American actors I can think of. But he always gets cast to play someone East Asian.
Right.
See, I mean, this doesn't look like... great, but it doesn't look horrible for a movie that is at this point.
And they look pissed because they're
old.
Sitting outside. Yeah. Also, why are they sitting outside?
Yeah. Just in case there's cruise ship guards that might see them. that was really, really quiet.
Yeah, there's a lot of that in this movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, will do. That's Dr. Mr. Comedy to you.
He reminds me of Apo.
Apone?
Yeah, Apone. I haven't watched Alien in a long time.
What's that?
Because it is inferior to the original.
You did say Alien instead of Aliens.
You know what I meant.
Look concerned real quick.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Okay. And cut. Hey, surfboard.
Yeah, surfboard. Now that I know it's a thing in the movie,
I know,
I'm going to see
like,
it everywhere.
It's right in my face.
The good old suction cup on a stick.
Hey, that's like the arm bike I had to use at my physical therapy.
It's like one of those PDAs you see people at big box stores using.
Early BlackBerry. Yeah. These graphics are totally unnecessary.
Yeah, yep. They are.
But how else would you know he's hacking?
Right. He's hacking time.
He's hacking the planet.
Yes, Good Brews, Bad Views, the podcast where we reference both Hackers and Kung Fury.
Right.
A movie James refuses to watch.
I like that he's like, you're not going to need your guns, as if he thinks that they're just going to go on the ship and pleasantly mingle with everyone else.
Right. Yep. Steady, Robin. We must ascend this building.
Hey, more, you know,
flotation devices.
Plot items.
Where are the fun noodles?
That would be a great weapon in this case.
Only if they're the ones with the holes in the middle, so you can shoot water out of them.
Yeah. Other unsuspecting leisure havers.
This movie has a ban on any garment that isn't black.
Right.
Why would he know that? Unless...
Probably through communications with, what, Canton? Is that his name?
Yeah, I get... Well, I don't remember anyone's name in this movie because
right,
they barely ever use anyone's name in this
true
movie.
True story. It's fine. It's totally fine, you guys.
Yeah.
And
Finnegan,
like, does he kind of also look like Nathaniel Drake?
Eh.
Like Nathan Fillion, almost. Yeah. Add that one to the mutt mix, too.
Yep. Yeah. Mmm.
Snaz
wine.
Snazberry. Yeah.
Remember, I'm Australian?
Yeah.
I actually found this very small scene to be kind of disturbing the first time I saw this movie. Just the whole empty elevator.
Mm. Yeah.
It's like,
He looks so concerned right there.
I'm trying to... I know I've seen Treat in other movies.
Well, he looks like four other people as we've gone over.
But I know it was Axe. It was definitely him.
And so begins this movie's obsession with elevators.
Mm.
Nice and smoky in that elevator.
Yeah.
It's a smoky vader.
That guy loves technology way too much. There's also a lot of dramatic door opening in this movie.
Again, with the soundtrack right here.
Yeah,
too.
It's just... It's cheesier than the movie.
It's like somebody wanted it. Like
maybe they're all inside this beach ball.
It's been a huge storm this whole time. Who blew up that beach ball?
Yeah.
It was probably set up preemptively.
There's a couple scenes where there's just like an inexplicable beach ball just hanging out. Who holds up? What the...
Yeah, that was holding an assault rifle like
assault
a pistol.
Assault rifle at full arms length like the pistol. Shut up.
I'm still thirsty, though.
Scenes.
I need the punch.
Was it red punch or was it blue punch?
gonna just take some of that. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Here we go.
I also love
masculinity. Masculinity.
I love the statement earlier on that these weapons have 1,000 round capacity. Where are all these bullets kept?
Yeah, because as if you when they shoulder their guns, you can see that there is a spot for the clip, and there's no clip.
Like I said, it's because they filmed this movie and people questioned the guns, and so they went back and just redid that scene where they just added in all the stuff they forgot.
Yeah.
Yep, there it is.
Yep.
Loud noises.
Loud noises.
Oh, that's the last time I binge on broccoli and string beans.
Yeah. Waking up from a terrible Jolly Green Giant nightmare. He's actually trying to sell me boat insurance.
Ho, ho, ho.
Now I really want to know what's in those jars.
All right, this is a pervy observation, but later there's a costume change with this chick, and I'm wondering where she got her bra later on, because I don't think she has one now.
Maybe it's one of those, like, strapless things?
Maybe.
This is a good good movie electronic sequence.
Yeah,
here.
This is how all electronics are designed. If it breaks, just open everything. Brought to you by Hollywoodtronics. Oh, it does say Acme on the side. No, it doesn't. I'm just saying that.
It should.
Acme Security. Is that actually a thing? It might be.
The real-world equivalent is Ajax. Mm.
You mean Francis.
Correct. Well,
so, the fire axe scene is amazing.
Yep. We're not there yet.
I know. I don't
patience,
want to spoil it for anybody.
Ryan, patience.
I'm so giddy about it.
We got a lot more generic action-y 90s computer screens to go through.
True, true.
His hat's backwards, but it's a form-fitting one. So you know he's all business because it's form-fitting.
Right.
But he's casual because it's backwards.
Exactly.
I do appreciate that you can still see the sticky thing on the side of the boat.
Yeah.
In these scenes.
Good continuity. Yeah. This bummed me out, man.
What is she doing?
Welding.
Also,
welding what?
I don't know. Metal.
Like she's literally just like flaming that steel.
It turns out she has no mechanical knowledge and she's just fucking around. She's just like, this looks like fun. Always wanted to turn this thing on.
I play with the torpedo launcher for no reason at all.
Yeah. So this is the one guy of the crew that I'm like, eh, about. Because I originally thought that was the British hacker tech fondler guy. But no, he's just some generic white guy.
Yeah. Generic cracker.
That's not, I don't know what she's, that's not how welding works.
It's not how anything works.
That's right.
But, no.
And notice the water went over it there and it didn't sizzle or anything, so it's clearly not getting hot.
Yeah. With the
also that
goofishly fake body.
That guy has been dead for a really long time.
If
that's
he looks
a,
like that, yeah.
That's just an inconvenient dead body that's in the ocean.
Right. With no clothes on.
Yeah. Right.
Well, I'm out in this rain. Oh,
wait, why am I out?
This is a brutal cut, though, man. This is...
Butts. Oh, no, that wasn't a butt. That looked like a butt.
That's just a wound.
A butt wound.
Like, she hits her fucking head on that thing, man.
Yep.
Jesus.
Like how he has that thing in the clamp, but it's not actually within the clamp.
Yeah.
Yeah, stupid bastards trying to save themselves on a sinking ship.
Yeah, bunch of pricks. I love that exchange. That's pretty good. Ladies.
I can smell the Vegemite in your breath. Comically sized wrenches, even though I know wrenches that big do exist.
Is this Carrot Top's floating workshop?
So how are you guys enjoying your beers for this week?
I'm liking mine. I don't know if it's I've been drinking a lot more IPAs recently because of the podcast, but this one's pretty good.
I've had mine before, and it's one of my favorite beers.
Yeah, Sin Eater is good stuff.
It is,
so
yeah.
I'm doing it well.
The one you chose for today, Max, is also excellent.
Yeah, yeah. It's kind of like the short, soft parade, any of our listeners are familiar with that. But it's not as, like, punch you in the face with all the fruit. It's rather enjoyable.
Drops the peanut. Shit! It's the little things. I'm a simple, simple man.
Yeah, when I was watching that this morning, I'm like, wait, what, really? They just devoted an entire scene to a single peanut?
I love it.
Here's more of the Aliens vibe to
yeah,
this movie,
Isolation.
Too.
So yeah, this is kind of a good time to... I mean, it's a pretty lengthy scene of him just wandering
down
the hallway.
There's no... I mean, watching the scene of him by himself in this creepy flooded corridor, you know that... I don't want to say T-Bone, but T-Ray, whatever, T-Rex, is he's got not long to live. Hey, Dutch Angles.
Yeah.
Straight out of Batman 66.
I do like the gag / jump scare in this scene, too.
Mm-hmm.
It's a fun bit. That's disgusting, by the way, also. Yes, there you go, T-Ray. Don't do that. Don't drink the ocean.
Yeah, no.
I'm a little confused by that action.
Yeah.
In what context does that make sense for his character or the movie?
It never makes any sense.
Are his eyebrows sculpted? Yes. Yes, they are.
Does it? He looks like Colin Farrell to me.
A little bit. Ah, ghost of me dad. He always said I would be an electrician.
I just like that they play with the whole, like, tentacle concept
there. Yeah, that was a good little scare there.
It's fun.
Hey, Ryan, you should have another beer. Thanks, Ryan.
I really do appreciate how long this movie holds the monsters back.
Yeah, I will definitely give it that. Like, as cheesy and as many jokes as we are making about this, it definitely does a fairly well Lovecraftian kind of story.
About
how small man is and how much of a slow burn it is until you actually realize what's going on. And then the extent of which, it's much bigger than it originally seems.
Yeah. The creature itself, too. I mean, I think that's one of the reasons why I appreciate it is that the actual, even the small creatures themselves are really, really creepy looking and scary. And to hold them back that long is really good.
Yeah.
Yep.
There's a continuity glitch here. So the gun, as a plot device, just plops right in front of these guys on the table. But
yeah, the gun falls through time and space.
And there's a zoom shot in about 10 seconds where the gun is not on the table.
Oh.
Yeah, like why are they being accused?
Yeah, where's the gun?
Where's the gun?
Yeah.
Again, follow through time and space.
Bum,
bum, bum, ba da, ba, ba.
It does look like the Legendary Pictures logo.
Yes. When I rewatched this movie yesterday, I actually laughed out loud at this scene.
Oh, this?
Yeah.
Trillian. Okay, that's her name. Yeah. Like, as James was saying, I could not remember the names of anyone in this movie because they never actually used them.
He's so happy.
Yep. I legit did not see that coming at all.
Goes from 0 to 100 in like 10
frames.
I
was expecting a bunch of dead bodies within the vault.
And then Jesus Christ.
No one is happy at all.
Yeah, that is amazing. That's great. Just out of left field. But it makes sense. That's a sensible thing to happen given the situation.
Well, the one thing I did bring up is that over the rest of this movie, the creature just brute forces its way through everything else.
Yeah.
So in this scene, they're assuming that the creature has managed to figure out how doors work, like Jurassic Park velociraptors.
Keypads. Keycards.
Keycards, even, yeah. I mean, I get they're scared, but it's still like...
Yeah.
Yep. Fun nice catch, anything. Treat.
Whee! Oh!
He keeps hitting all the strawberry jam tubes.
Yeah.
See, this is why OSHA has regulations about where you need to store compressed gas containers.
Oof.
Well, it's weird because here and in the last step, we both saw like explosions of blood. But in the future scenes when we actually see the monster, it always just swallows the body whole.
I assumed with this, it just had to do with the water in the area.
Yeah, I suppose.
I mean, I'm not really looking for any kind of like crazy logic in this movie or anything, but you bring up a good point.
Yeah, yeah. In the instances where they're being consumed unobstructed. Like, there's nothing else around them. So in these, they could be pulled through a smaller opening or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A la the blob.
It does fit with the, like, pulling the lady through the toilet scene.
Yeah.
It's another instance of a really cool scene.
Yeah.
Tremors 6. Practical this time it's too. On a boat.
Yeah. But one of the reasons that I like this right here too is that it makes this creature terrifying. It just killed these two guys with them without them being able to do anything.
Yeah.
Right? But doesn't give away anything about the creature at all.
Yeah. Wait, is the monster having sex on top of the...
Same ceiling.
Yep, it is the same ceiling.
Every time. I was actually in an elevator once when it got stuck, and I was horrified. I can't imagine how this...
Shoe
goes.
Attack!
Next is George W. Bush.
Oh, it's okay. Hi. You're hot.
Yeah, you're hot. You can freak out now.
Quiet, you.
Same thing.
Just pan in the opposite direction.
All right.
So she's wearing...
look like Nathan Fillion.
I'd like to point out that she's wearing flats.
Yeah.
About... a decade before they become popular.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Very
but then again,
forward.
She's a sneaky kind of thief, so I would expect sneaky thieves to be wearing flats. So
yeah, not,
she
not
is what she's
flats.
Doing.
True, yeah.
Like, she has a very sensible wardrobe change.
Yeah, and that scene actually is pretty well done, because they show that she's going to change, and then they cut away and do a bunch of other stuff, and when they cut back, she's changed.
Instead of just flashing her all over the place.
Right, yeah, there's no crazy amount of, like, ogling or anything. Yeah, she's just, like, this needs to happen.
He said bloody, that's how you know he's British.
Right.
Yeah.
Plus, they are literally bloody.
Yeah, that's true. I like it that it also, in reality, this would have just ended the movie.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
And it's over.
Well,
if the brakes were working at all.
Yeah.
But the doors blasting
maybe
out of the...
some broken legs.
Yeah.
Depending on how far it fell.
The amount of force that they suggest occurs at the end of this drop is fairly severe.
Yeah, because it goes to secret level 3.
This is also a ride at Disneyland.
Right.
It is, yeah.
An elevator dropping is a ride.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, I know.
I've been on that ride.
It just seems, the more you think about that, the more ridiculous it seems.
Leviathan yeah. Cruise Ship Murder Fest?
No, just elevator dropping.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
The Tower of Terror.
Yeah.
I guess that's technically what, MGM Studios?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, or not even, they changed the name like 3 other times.
It's, oh, have they?
I can't remember what it's called now. Hollywood Magic or whatever it is. Yep.
Okay.
Something like that.
Whee! It's got some breakage going on there. Once they hit bottom, I mean.
Oh, they come flying out of here.
At the bottom of an elevator.
But this here.
Secret 3.
Dang! The door is flying off the thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're all dead or severely crippled.
Yeah.
This
was one of my favorite scenes in the movie.
And just the shot reminds me very much of the incredible Cabin in the Woods movie, the kind of the pinnacle of the ultraviolence.
Oh, yeah.
A bit of the old ultraviolence.
Exactly.
This also reminds me of the hallway scene in Metal Gear Solid.
Right, the first one.
Yeah.
Gray Fox.
No guns for you.
He used his name.
Ooh, that's what, twice
you
now?
Keep you, yep, and your chin out of this, Finnegan.
Again, I think this was written for Bruce Campbell.
Yeah. This hallway is a legitimately really well done set design.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now what? The movie's endearing but appropriately,
my catchphrase, eh?
Yeah, exasperated saying.
Like, you can tell that's like bad CGI, but it's not that terrible.
I think this is practical.
Yeah, I think this is practical, CGI, too.
It looks like really flimsy metal that they're just pushing in from the sides. I don't think this is,
yeah, I have the same feeling. And I think the rivets are just glued onto the wall so that they pop off whenever the metal gets bent enough.
Okay, yeah, I'll give you that. I mean, that's what this movie, like,
that's horrifying.
That's horrifying practical effects.
God, that's, yeah.
Yeah.
Like, this movie, like, it crosses that line back and forth of practical and CGI. So, you know, like you said, like, that metal flimsy and folding there, like, that looks practical now. Like, right. But when it's actually bending out, it could go either way. Just because of, like, the lighting and the blood strains make it kind of look difficult, but.
Oh, no.
And Cranium
Max's
crush.
Drink right there.
Yep.
And that's what causes all this to happen.
Well, that one guy's had his leg hurt. The captain. Captain Atherton.
Yep. Probably from that elevator.
And the sticky things are still up, which is good. Yep.
Otherwise, the boat would have blown away.
And we have an instance of a character not knowing another character's name, because I don't remember her name either.
No.
It's Layla.
Is it?
Layla.
Something like that.
See?
Layla. I like how those torpedoes are all armed.
And floating somehow.
Buoyant cases.
Yeah.
There's a lot of foam in those cases, Ryan.
Clearly. Negative densities.
Yep. Chick with muscles.
The ocean.
At least he's not calling her like Asian tart or something like that. Hand gestures. Yeah, even in the background there, Famke Johnson's going directly towards the clothes.
Yep.
Rife Bosch.
Checking out shoes.
Yep. Because the Marines are totally going to get you in the South China Sea when you're 800 miles away from any sort of land.
Yeah.
Speaking of flashlights.
Did you say flashlights?
It did sound like that, but no. Those are way overpriced. Anyway, there's a scene later on where there are three characters, including Joey. They all have guns with flashlights on them. And the camera cuts to where all the flashlights are lined up, and I appreciate that before that, Joey's shaking a lot, and when it cuts to the three lights on the wall, there is one of them that's shaking a lot.
Oh, really?
That's a nice little touch. I'm an intimidating black man. You will listen to me.
I like that Shaggy and Scooby here figure out who the bad guy is in like 1 second.
Right. Yep. Zoinks.
Point six.
It's probably because he's taken into account depreciation already.
Right.
Well, here's the thing, though. He might have taken into depreciation, but he does terrible on realizing that his dream yacht is, or not dream, dream cruise liner is a money pit.
Yeah. See? And now she's suddenly just changed.
Right, there you go.
I forgot to carry the one.
And, you know, as far as sexualization of people in movies, I'm more okay with it if it's for both genders. I mean, don't make it just one. Unless that's the point of the movie, like Magic Mike, but
whatever. Yeah. Well, I just thought it was interesting because they kind of do like a whole like how look how sultry she is,
right,
and this
right.
and that.
Yeah.
And then this scene happens and they completely just have it happen off screen, basically.
Right, yeah, absolutely. Completely agree. So this is funny. Did you guys notice he slaps it in the second here? Keep an eye out for it. And the CGI responds to it, which is another small touch that I like.
Oh, he slaps the creature?
Yeah. Keep an eye out for it.
Oh, yeah. Like,
what? Yeah.
And the big reveal, sort of.
Yeah. I mean, this legitimately doesn't look like as awful as it could be.
Right.
That shot of the hand against the tentacle.
Right.
That reminded me a lot of Anaconda.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. When the guy's getting eaten, you see his face going against.
And this is some horrifying shit. I remember this freaked me out.
This
a lot,
is the
too.
One CGI that I have a real like problem with. Like if they did all of this as practical, that would have been much more horrifying than it actually is.
Yeah.
And this CGI you see here of the guy's like half formed face, you see a lot in The Mummy, which is also directed by Steven
Summers.
Steven Summers.
See, I didn't think this
looked... Imhotep's half-formed face when he comes out of the sarcophagus initially.
Yeah, I like the way that looks. I think it looks pretty good.
Yeah, I thought that looked pretty decent myself.
It was just like the side view when you could just see like into the brain and like the half-formed muscles or half-devoured muscles.
And this is when you can kind of start to see... again,
those guns sound funny, sorry.
The rendering and the textures are great on this, but the lighting is what really makes the effects seem out of place.
Yeah.
And when I say the lighting, I mean the lighting on the CGI models.
Well, this movie has problems with lighting.
Just
like,
generally?
All over, and generally, like, in the last scene before you see Sagat here, like, there was a couple guys in the hallway, and you couldn't really see
who's
anything.
Who
is who. You could just see general outlines, and you had to rely on the hat to see that it was the second in command.
And she's dead.
Good thing he didn't have an axe.
Yeah.
plus 10 for James.
Mm-hmm. Very Kurt Russell expression on his face.
Yeah.
Also Kurt Russell.
I do appreciate that he's kind of just genuinely a good guy in this movie.
Yeah.
I love this.
This is good.
This looks
this
great.
Really, this
still
holds
looks
up
really
well.
Good.
I love like against the knob.
Valve there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So this upcoming revelation about how these things like operate and work, this whole thing. Oh, look, slow motion. And then they figured out he never tells this to everybody else. So is
the
that
sound?
Vagina dentata.
Teeth, another good movie. Watch that one.
The whole thing that like they hear they work by sound and not sight. He never tells the crew that. So is this revelation just supposed to be for the audience?
They've all seen it by now. Like everyone's only smoothly seen it. They know it doesn't have any eyes.
Yeah, but I mean, there's later scenes where they're like, they know it's around, and everyone's just kind
of
like, la 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 la.
Okay, yeah. I'm not going to get into them in the mechanics of how giant tentacly monsters.
No, I just thought it was interesting that the movie goes way out of its way to be like, this thing here or works its way around the ship by hearing stuff. And then the main character who
notices it
literally never tells anybody else.
Okay.
Like, you'd think that the first time that they got to... I was waiting through the whole movie when I was rewatching it again, when they were in a big group and it was around them, for him to be like...
To share that information?
For him to be like...
Be very, quiet. Very quiet. We're hunting deep ones.
Yeah, basically. Like, hey, be quiet.
Leg wound progresses into more serious leg wound.
Yeah. So everyone's ready to fire, and...
And he's being sucked into a... oval shaped.
Yeah. Oh god.
That's bad.
Yeah, the teeth kind of like wrapping up around him, enveloping him.
Nobody fires until he's gone though.
Yeah.
Like, they're all waiting.
Yeah.
Maybe he'll just pull him out of the mouth without us firing any shots.
Probably.
They probably had to conserve
well,
some
as
of
you
that.
Can see, well, even from like the hand going like the hand up against the skin from that initial revelation, you know that they're still alive. In a sense?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So.
This guy gives you some planet Earth definitions of these
crazy
monsters.
Stop mansplaining.
More exposition.
I'm not trusting any math you say, man.
Yeah, right. He admitted it.
Her gun changes from black to silver in this scene, too, by the way. Yeah.
I mean, it was silver initially.
Maybe auto tints like your glasses.
Transition lenses?
Transition handguns.
When it's on the table and she picks it up, it's black.
I thought it was...
Which is just horrible.
Oh, yeah. That scared the crap out of me as a kid. Because we were all of what? Like...
Probably
barely teenagers when we watched this movie.
Yeah, sounds about right.
Yeah, I mean, that's, you know, being just like killed, but then like getting to the actual description of how it's done, that's another thing entirely.
Yeah, that's pretty intense.
That valve looks very important based on how much focus is
getting. Yeah, a lot of screen time for that one. Must have a good agent.
I'll give it to this movie. There's a lot of like electrical hazards, chevrons, and just hazard warnings in general, like in places that I would expect them to be. Like, it's these sets look like they're an actual ship's bow, which for all I know they could be. I didn't look into much of like Deep Horizon. And there we go. Deep Horizon, Deep Rising, rent out actual ships to film this stuff. So
yeah. That's good.
Actually, that was leading me to a thought. I'm wondering what this movie's budget was, because a lot of this seems like fairly expensive set design.
Oh, yeah.
With all the water and everything.
A lot of those, like, a lot of this piping and ducts and all that stuff, that's not cheap stuff. Like, look at that. There's like...
Yeah, I mean, that's a full hallway, man.
Yeah.
I mean, they likely used the same section of set. Shot in different ways.
Yeah, I'm sure
the
hallways we've seen are used throughout several different scenes. But...
Right.
The budget was $45 million, right? I just looked it up.
In 1998.
$1998. It was a pretty sizable budget for a
movie of this magnitude.
Yeah.
Any idea on the revenue on that?
Let me look.
To the interweb.
The speaking of the
the song was in his head.
Speaking of the the design and everything and the signage and stuff, just from the alien and alien vibes we're talking about. Have you looked up how they designed an entire set of signage for Alien?
I'm not surprised, but I did see an article on how about all the different kind of text for Blade Runner, which, you know.
Yeah.
1980s. It's during the second golden age of sci-fi.
Yeah. Oh, no. So, the domestic total for this movie, lifetime, is $11.2 million.
Oh,
and
no.
I helped.
Oh, no.
But that's just theatrical run, right? That's probably not.
No, if it's a lifetime run, that includes
that's total lifetime grosses.
That's box office.
That's
home box
unfortunate
office.
For this movie. It's also God's fault.
That's domestic only, though.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, maybe it was just like Warcraft and China saved it.
Just blasted everything out of the water elsewhere.
Yeah.
That wasn't supposed to be a aquatic pun.
I'm too old for this shit.
Yeah. Those guys.
I like
making...
how he says it has a hell of a kick, and when she actually does shoot it, like, she gets knocked back.
Yeah, she falls back.
Yeah. I like that those two just make bad revives.
Yes, the indescript
other.
Parts in a very, very small backpack.
Yeah.
Also, they all dive into the water here. You don't need to dive into that water.
Yeah,
you do.
It's an efficient way to get depth and just kind of forward momentum. Mm. Everyone else just belly flops after this.
You pointed this out, so I'll give you credit for it, Max.
Mm-hmm.
But there's... you can hear music in the background
here.
Well,
it starts off here.
But
like,
then it goes away, doesn't it?
Yeah. If you're listening, music.
And again, this is just... It's a relatively decent scene here.
Yeah, it's, you know...
And it's tense.
It's one of the things where I think the lighting is actually good. Yep, all right. No music.
Yeah.
No music, no water sounds, no kicking, just straight silence. I mean, it's
just the bubble noises.
Yeah, the exhaling, but it's unsettling. It's, I don't know. Which I imagine if you were in the situation, this would be a very
unsettling
situation. You're swimming through these underwater corridors. You don't know. And then, yeah, the hand.
Yeah.
I guess that have that
the ship's like let me give you a hand.
The severed hand coming up is apt. Also, when did those guys get out of the water?
They're right there.
Found a soaked bloke.
The only thing I have to say about this scene that I thought, and it's such a nitpicky thing, and I fully admit it, is they talk about how it's 20 meters long. If this is a U.S. release, just make it a football field.
Yeah,
because that's what people know what it is, or put it in
half
yards.
A football field.
This is my favorite line. Can you just get asthma? it stuck with me through the years.
The tremors are coming back.
Save us, Kevin Bacon.
Stop looking more shutting.
They don't like to shut doors in this movie.
I like how that's animated. It's like it's spilling into the hallway.
It's...
Again, the CGI in it, that CGI doesn't look particularly great, but the effect that it has is still really good.
Yeah, right. Plus it has the benefit of it gives the notion of they're moving so fast that you don't really need much individual focus on the frame to frame basis.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's fine. It's totally fine. Here it is.
Okay, the one
on top is shaking.
I was expecting someone to be hit by that door.
Yeah. And there she goes.
Yep, into the water.
Yeah, I mean, right there, the lighting's obviously really bad on it. But it's still, I mean, it's still creepy enough as it works.
Yeah.
He jumped into the water like he was jumping onto a motorcycle. Yeah. He just kind of falls.
Yeah.
You notice that he has a normal gun still, even though he had to give her his gun before.
I think maybe he had two.
Yeah, but that whole point of that scene is him being like, "Well, I guess I'll give up my gun,"
right.
And then he just has another one anyway, which in and of itself is kind of funny.
Yeah.
I was surprised they didn't make a joke out of that, like him being like, "Oh, I guess I'll give it to you," and then be like, "Well, I got another one."
Just pull another one out.
Yeah.
For a second, I'm like, really? You're going to have the African-American drown?
Oh.
This is a pretty sweet move on his part, though.
Yeah.
Through the butt. I like that shot there.
another homage.
Plus, they have grenades.
Yeah, another homage to Aliens right here.
Mm. Yep.
And Joey's eardrums are just gone.
They are both bleeding from the ears.
And his eyeballs are ruptured and everything.
I often wonder, how did they find out about that? How did people find out about that? If there's an explosion under the water, and there's people under the water...
It's not good.
It's a bad time.
Yeah.
My chin. My chin's next.
The askew glasses are a fun little touch.
Yeah, with his one thing.
Yeah. They're around all the bread. That's why he said jam.
Mm-hmm.
I like how she's eating again.
Yeah.
Is she the Brad Pitt of this movie? All at Ocean's 11?
Ocean's 11? Yeah.
Just like there's no way they could get in here from our impenetrable hull.
Right. Yeah. More exposition in a second.
This is like the closest thing this movie gets to like an actual mutiny, which I was expecting to happen at some point of a group of the mercenaries being like, fuck this shit, we're leaving now.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Give us those indescript boat parts. Mucking about.
All right, Mulligan, you want to try again?
Bravo.
A plus, Ryan.
I'm really surprised that joke isn't in this movie.
Yeah, I don't know if the writers are that clever enough. I mean, my writers, I mean writer, as it was written and directed by
Mr. Summers.
Here you go. Have you seen that article about how octopus DNA is actually completely different from how like the DNA structure of pretty much every other animal on Earth works?
No, I have not, but tell me more.
Yeah, I have to read it again to get into it, but the point of it that they're trying to make is that it's like it's not completely out of the realm of possibility that octopi are not necessarily
not
related
to this world.
Yeah. Which is interesting, because they're also not being affected by the warming of the oceans right now.
Really?
As everything else is reducing in population, they're increasing.
Okay, yeah. So the whole point of that story Finnegan just told about the octopi is then he went to a nice Greek restaurant in his hometown and, you know, got that octopus cooked into a nice, put into a nice salad.
I like that he isn't immediately killed here.
Yeah. Yeah, that would have just been like,
right.
Oops, he got killed.
Yep, because the lead up here is like, who's behind me?
He realizes
then,
what's behind him.
There you go, over the shoulder. Wise move.
Yes.
Yeah.
Of course.
Take the bread!
I like that he acts like a trained mercenary here.
Yeah.
Except for the whole advancing aspect right there. It's a convenient fire.
Yeah. Also, there's a little bit of a nuanced thing here. The implication kind of in that last scene is that the fire scares it away.
Yes.
And then he shuts it off and it comes back.
Well, it's like Alien, you know. Fire scares it away. So said Bishop. Or not Bishop. Ash. Wrong android. Sorry.
You don't want fire on a boat. It's bad.
Oh, and it's keeping away sea monsters. I'll make an exception.
That's true.
Oh, no, it didn't come back. It was a different tentacle.
Yeah.
It still
or
comes
it's the same one that circled around.
Mm, yeah.
But again, it is the absence of fire.
Was that a Wilhelm scream, too?
I don't think so, but I wasn't listening real hard the second time, to be honest.
Okay.
What did I watch the other day that had the Wilhelm scream in it again? I don't remember.
Oh, God. They've learned how to use knobs. We're doomed. Sewage treatment. We don't want to go there anyway.
Right. Yeah.
Now, something that I kind of want your guys' opinion on. Are there individual small ones, or are they all part of the larger creature?
They're all part of the larger creature.
Right.
I don't know.
Because it's not super clear, but the implication, I think, is that they're all part of the larger creature.
Yeah.
I feel like they're all part of the larger creature.
I think it is, but...
I think that's supposed to be part of the reveal, is you never see anything beyond, like, beyond 10 or 15 feet, and it's so just pervasive throughout the entire ship.
Yeah.
Right. Although I feel like they could function on their own if...
If severed?
Yeah, I guess the only reason why in my...
I'm no cryptozoologist, but...
Yeah. In my mind, why I go back and forth about it is that there's no, like, massive hole in the ship for where the big one would have come through, but it shows that these things can fit in all sorts of tiny spaces.
Yeah,
anyway.
Yeah, I mean...
Very octopi-like.
When you see that fisheye lens of... when you see that fisheye lens of the creature... coming in, you see it's of the rotor.
Gross.
And now we see our obviously evil white guy being obviously evil.
My evil is so obvious.
And here we come up to one of my favorite reveals in this entire movie.
This is a great reveal.
And I was thinking, aside from right here, the actors are never shown again in the same shot as all this stuff, so I'm pretty sure this is all a miniature.
Yeah. Might be.
That's a lot of skeletons. Yeah.
Be our guest. Flay the skin from your chest. Crush your eyes to make some sauce.
This is such a good reveal as to how horrifying this event is.
Right.
Yeah, because evil white guy said, like, oh yeah, they poop out your bones or whatever.
Yeah.
And that's probably where they poop out all the bones.
I mean, it just kind of jams home how poorly written the rest of the movie is when you have such a horrifying reveal like this that doesn't fit with anything.
Here's how the giant thing comes in.
That's probably your point, yeah. Because the rest is just the tentacles coming up through the ship, right. I bet.
But still, though, it's still not definitive. It also could be the case where, like in the scene where we finally see it, that it's just surrounded by many little ones. Mm. It's not necessarily that they're attached, but I think that's
I feel like it's one giant one based off of actually the ending of the movie.
Right.
But we'll get to that when we get to that. It could be just that it's like attached to the outside of the ship. See. And then eventually it just, you know, makes its way inside.
Almost poured my beer on the floor. You know what? I don't think they drop an F-bomb in this movie.
They've dropped an F-bomb in the first, like, 5 minutes of this movie.
Did they?
Yeah. Like, in the first scene on the boat, she was like, what the fuck are you doing out here?
Right.
Yeah.
But then it's just, like, the once, though.
A couple more times, but it's not...
It's pretty tame in the language department is what I'm
getting
at.
Yeah.
I like this.
Like, I feel like if this movie was made today, it probably could have been made PG-13 other than a few of the gorier stuff.
I think so. I think it has just enough concept of gore to it that it sticks to other stuff to be creepy, though.
Right.
Yeah.
Slowly closing door for no reason.
My parts! My indistinct parts!
And a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Oh, no. Bad green screen.
Yeah, really.
Open the blast doors.
Dick move Sagat coming up here. Love this guy's voice.
Yeah.
Well, Benny.
Goodbye.
Yeah. Again, the whole spilling aspect here is
really cool. Yeah, it kind of just spills forth, which,
yeah,
if you read a lot of Lovecraft's literature, like, they don't, the, a lot of his creatures don't move in the way that we would expect things to move. They kind of just, like, fall forward, right. Or not really fall, yeah, but
almost
just,
flow.
Yeah, yeah. That's a good way of putting it. Flow. I'm going to use that.
Pudding.
Do you think arrows on that island?
Well, obviously. Slapping it around with.
They are in the South China Sea.
Yeah.
You got a better boat? I have a bigger boat. Someone asked for that once.
Oh, God. Yeah. It's cool because they still assume it's multiple creatures because they're like, what are those things are crawling
yeah,
inside
right,
of it?
Right, right.
Yeah.
Which we'll assume is just one big thing. They also changed the very sensible docking shoes. Or boat shoes.
Yeah. Ow. Ow.
This was a pretty cool scene here.
I love
just
this
the karma.
Scene. Yeah. I think this
the,
is such...
I think the cheapness of that sign is yeah. Nice.
This whole... Everything about this, like, 2 minutes is
yeah.
So good.
Yeah. I love this. I love everything about this next coming 2 minutes.
Yeah. Again, another scene that shows, like, there's a really good movie
somewhere
inside
in here,
of this movie.
Yeah. Oh, gun. I was kind of expecting to see him being, like, severed from the... Like the waist,
right?
This is so
but
much
this
better.
Nice, like slow reveal of
mm-hmm.
Yeah,
what's happening to this guy?
Do you think this is how he loses his eye and gets that scar in his chest?
Well, no. This
yeah.
is how this is what happens afterwards. He took the bison bucks to get his eye replaced.
Right. But it's a cool choice here that he's unable to speak, which...
or he just chooses not to.
I
or
don't
not,
think
not
he's
scream.
Able to.
I think he's in such pain that
he
can't.
Right.
Yeah,
his brain
really
just like
to...
we have no way to speak.
Yeah, I think that he's just so shut down.
I like that he comes. I like that Benny or Coochie or Joey comes back and gives him the gun.
Right.
Yeah.
As a way to being like you know like. Yeah,
yeah.
Like you know, let me put you out of this pain, as opposed to like him yeah. actually shooting him. And then Sagat, like, actually trying to shoot him.
Screams at him.
Great.
The one thing I would have done different... I love this. This is perfect.
But then, like, yep. when you see them trying to shoot, you can kind of tell this beat's coming of him trying to act, you know, off himself.
Yeah.
And
the one bullet he used to be an asshole. The one thing I would have changed about how that was shot is when Joey was running away... Not showing Sagat lining up the shot first, just,
and just
having
seeing,
the bullet
like,
ricochet.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know why he sends her to do this. Like, I guess he's getting the boat ready to go. Maybe.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Probably.
Convenient.
I mean, that's probably what's going
on. Jet ski is convenient.
Yeah. Or unless he's telling her to go get the jet ski, it seems like it's kind of.
It seems like, well, has no radio, and he has no radio, so it seems like it was a verbal command, but, or his voice just carries a lot. Well, that window is open, so.
Well, I mean, no, he's just yelling at her, and I guess my thing is that it's not clear whether or not he's telling her to get the keys for the boat, or get the keys for
Why would the keys
ski.
For the boat be in the jet ski bay?
Because he doesn't know where anybody else is.
Well,
hey, Benny.
I like that we've renamed him Benny.
Yeah. I like how we've renamed Sagat.
Yeah. It's because nobody's name in this movie matters.
This is how I knew his name was Joey, because he says Joey like 3 or 4 times right here.
The pants. And then I like, they're like, the movie's like, oh yeah, there was another character earlier.
Yeah.
Wait a second. He also looks like Brendan Fraser.
No, he doesn't.
Now it all makes sense.
The chin is not as protruded.
The jawline, though.
The jawline and the shape of the face and the hair.
Yeah.
It's like a proto-Brendan Fraser.
Proto-Fraser?
Yeah. Got me on my knees, Layla. That's only how I know her name, Layla. I'm kind of wearing a chef hat, Joey.
Yeah.
Wait, no, it has a bill.
You have to give Joey some credit here for immediately like going back to work.
Right. Yeah. For doing what's necessary.
Yeah.
And this is a kind of a moderately touching scene here with him on the job just becoming like, man.
I'll give this movie a pass for actually using goggles for the purpose that goggles are needed for. Mm-hmm. And the
not just tank girling them?
Yeah, not just not just fashion accessory.
Or just spraying fire onto water like Layla was doing at the beginning of the movie.
Yeah, but he had that single tear when he was
Yeah, that's good. That's a good little scene. And again with this really like overly cheesy music.
They really, really, really wanted a symphony for the music.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And they could just afford a guy with a Casio keyboard.
It's more like there was a soundtrack from another movie that didn't get made like 8 years prior. Like, let's just use that. It's Otto from Airplane.
The blow up guy.
I think that's still the same map from the very beginning.
There are various
movie.
Little itty bitty islands.
Yeah.
I'm really surprised he doesn't kick it in this scene.
Yeah, just be like
his penchant for kicking earlier in this movie.
Yeah,
yeah, but Joey's corrected him a couple times. We already saw it. Be gentle.
Yeah, but I guess I thought there would have been like kind of a funny like you're supposed to be gentle. And
yeah,
finally,
and then
he kicks it.
Not gentle, and it works. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah.
I mean, it's hit all like the stereotypes of action movies beforehand. You expect the kick.
Yeah.
To come. You and your personifications of machines.
It seems like an incredibly, like, overly secure ski-do.
These are very rare jet skis, James. That was an
double-barreled flare gun.
Do you want this key?
I want this key. I want it. That's how it works, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
More exposition.
Yeah.
Whoops.
Trips over unseen object.
Tripped over the water. Time Splitters 3 would be very proud right now.
As would TF2.
Yeah, so he has three names in this movie. He has Joey, Pantucci, and Tooch.
Yeah. I thought his name was Cooch for the most of this movie.
It's a good dodge.
Yeah. It's the sensible shoes.
Yeah. Right. I'm glad that he remembered to grab extra flares.
I like that they show him reloading the flare gun.
Yeah.
I also really like that look of the shoulder back slung.
Yeah, that's pretty sweet.
Shotgun.
Yeah.
Used to good effect at the big reveal in a moment here. This is just such an overused cinematic trick here. Pan in this direction and something will scare you when you get to the other end.
Yeah.
Ah! Creepy white guy.
So that implies that he's accidentally killed people before?
Well he accidentally killed the whole ship.
Yeah. Well,
yeah. Max is like, blah, blah, blah.
I thought that was like a separate event he was referring to, like some insurance fraud, arson thing.
Or he like paid to have somebody killed?
I'd say that's purposely trying to have someone killed.
I don't know.
I'm a little confused by this just intimidation here.
No, I feel like Finnegan graduated from the Stormtrooper School of Marksmanship.
Oh, yeah, right.
Top third
of his class.
I think this kind of goes along with the idea that he's just, like, a good guy.
He doesn't want to kill him.
He's not going to kill anybody.
Yeah. All right. I agree.
Yeah, because, see, I suppose he hasn't seen Evil McWhite Guy trying to actually kill anyone.
Yeah, he's just
other
being
than the
sleazy.
Reaction to the axe of the head.
Yeah.
Just had to ask him a question. I had to do it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, even if he...
Ryan, you're fired.
Yeah.
You're fired.
Even if he saw him trying to be, like, evil and trying to kill her, I still think, unless
exploding couch.
He was, like, killing him to prevent her
right.
from dying. I don't know if he'd do it. I think that's kind of the character that
he's a lawful good agree.
Captain.
This is another one of those instances where I'm not I'll sure hit it with if my these shoe. Are miniatures or not. Because you never see the actors in the same shot as any of this.
Mm.
And I believe back when I was growing up watching Movie Magic, which was a wonderful television show on Discovery Channel, I believe Deep Rising was on one of the episodes.
Oh, was it?
Yeah. And here's another thing where the difference in lighting is most noticeable on the creature. Like, it's muted. It's got a whiteness to it.
Yeah.
Well, that spotlight doesn't really help. Mm. Yeah, whiteness. Yeah, I see that. I feel like they're trying to force so many catch lines.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Well, that's why I say it seems like they wrote the script and just had a bunch of, like, reinsert dialogue here notes, but just went with it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Oh, no, I threw my gun away. Whatever shall I do?
Use my other gun that is strapped to my back, perhaps, but nah. I like how it punches him in the face.
Though. It's all quiet down, you.
Good sound effects as far as creature noises go here.
I agree.
Yeah.
And the creature design overall is pretty solid.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I like this. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
You're spitting your eye.
Motherfucker.
Boom.
Bang. Oh.
Yeah.
No more 3D movies for you, asshole.
No one ever needed 3D movies unless they were going to go see Tron Legacy or Dread.
Hey, shut your mouth. I love 3D.
Oh.
And I know I'm the only one.
We will have words after this, Brian.
I have a 3D-enabled TV, damn it.
Dread is good in 3D.
Well, it's, because of that slow-mo.
Yeah.
That slow-mo, though, bro.
Of the movies I've seen in 3D, the only two that I've enjoyed seeing in 3D, Dread and Tron Legacy.
There you go.
Avatar is the one I love the most.
Avatar was pretty good in 3D.
I haven't seen it.
IMAX 3D was
I'm not impressed
amazing.
By it.
Yeah.
Aw, Joey. Or Pantucci, or Tooch, or Benny, whoever Tooch, you are.
Benny. Joey.
Benny! Benny is now on the other side. Of the river Styx.
Oh boy.
Hey, Finnegan! It's like you.
If only he had handed that.
But
his
I feel like if this movie was made like 5 years later, Brendan Fraser would have been cast in the main role.
He gives Benny far more thought than Benny gave his own girlfriend.
True, yeah. Well, the most meaningful relationship in this whole movie is with Treat and Joey.
That's true.
It is, yeah. I would say British hacker guy was super, super, super pissed to hear that T-Ray was killed. Like, he was the most...
Yeah, distraught.
Distraught over the death of him.
The music here just ruins the whole tension of this scene.
I agree.
It's,
and he doesn't remember her name either.
No. I would say the music, it reminds me, thinking about it, it reminds me a little bit of the music from The Mummy.
It's
actually the score right now, particularly. Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah.
Very mummy-ish.
Yeah. This scene of a movie with that has pretty brutal scenes.
Oh,
this
it's
scene
cringe-worthy.
Is so, oh.
I was actually expecting it to be much more gruesome than it actually is. Like, have you guys seen Mount Pleasant with Pierce Brosnan?
No.
So Mount Pleasant is
Dante's Peak.
Oh yeah.
Yes, I know exactly what you're talking about.
When,
yep.
Like when the bone.
Oh yeah.
He breaks his arm and
it's a compound fracture.
Yeah, and it comes out of his arm. I remember seeing that when I was like
Dante's
8 or 9.
Peak is. Got some pretty cool shit in it. I remember that movie and like Volcano or the companion Volcano movies that kind of came out at the same time.
Late 90s
with Tommy Lee
ecological
Jones.
Disasters.
Yep.
I feel like right now this movie's trying to make up for Waterworld. Like, we are going to apologize. We'll make jet skis cool again.
And again, this is another thing that makes me think this was a fairly expensive movie for the time, because these big water sets here. Again, it's often probably the same hallway shot over and over, but still.
Yeah. Yeah.
But again, like, those, like, four or five tentacles just sort of just...
just flowing
forward, yeah. As opposed to...
It's really cool.
Yeah.
And one just, like, bumping the wounded one out of the way. That was kind of cool. But no, yeah.
Maybe the none of the scale makes sense on the map.
God, it's not as dramatic as I was expecting it to be. I was expecting more of a noticeable jut of his bone sticking out of his skin.
Yeah,
but I'm not going to complain about
that. Was a cool shot. Restraint. Just that real quick one, the overhead shot there. This implies that he saw this from like 900 feet away. They're doing 30 miles an hour for a good 10 seconds here.
He specializes in shotgun.
And he's also the world's most...
I do like that, how she is cocking the shotgun as opposed to him doing the Terminator
the
2.
The one-handed.
Reload.
Yeah. Reload. Reload.
It's... this whole sequence is pretty fun.
It is, yeah. I gave it that. I'll give it that.
It's kind of fun, the juxtaposition between these two, of they're completely healthy, but they have no control over what's going on, or they have complete control over what's going on, and he has no health to him, effectively.
Yeah.
Like he's wholly injured, but he
That's
has
a good
absolutely
point.
No
yeah.
control.
But still, the back of that seat up against him, it totally looks like a... proton pack.
Right.
Maybe that's just because I watched Ghostbusters last week.
Another hint, they actually, this is the biggest hint that the surfboard is important. Keep your eyes peeled when it explodes.
No. It's blatantly obvious why the surfboard is important.
Yeah.
Game over.
Game over.
My hands will protect me.
Surfboard.
Yep.
Yep.
Cause that when I first saw that, I'm like, wait, why is there a surfboard there?
It's a surfboard missile. Missile weary hard to get.
I do like that this goes through and shows all of the sets that we've seen get blown up.
Yeah, right.
Like,
yeah.
They must have had fun at the end of this movie blowing up all of their own sets.
We're finally done shooting. Fuck this.
Fuck this movie.
Pretty satisfying explosions overall.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's because they're real.
That's awful, green screen.
Yeah. That's no good.
Quick, luckily, we hit those boost arrows.
Yeah.
Because there was a transition from... originally, it was blue screen, and then they went mostly to green screen, and I think it was because of certain things like this and sensitivity issues with the cameras.
Okay.
I feel like a lot of that boat blowing...
That is the worst in the whole movie, though,
right
there.
That was real bad.
Yeah. And there's no reason to show that, either. Just naming the monster and fire.
Well, yeah.
And if they were going to show the main creature being destroyed, they didn't have to do a close-up.
No.
It could have been a far-back shot in that whole, ballroom area, you know?
Yeah. It's kind of the same with the... With the jet ski jumping out, they could have just shown a faraway shot with the jet ski.
Or the boat blowing up, and you see the remnants of the creature's head kind of, burning.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
Shot to shit.
No.
Unlike you guys, I really did not like Joey Coochie Benny's character.
Joey Coochie Benny.
So originally I thought he died, and the movie is robbing us of the satisfaction of seeing him actually being killed. And then this happens.
But the surfboard.
Yeah. I thought he was actually died though.
I actually like the reiteration of that line.
The cold
with the
beard,
different
yeah.
tones.
Yeah.
No, I guess we're stuck on this island. And he's like, well, I guess we're stuck on this island.
Yep. Like, how are you still alive?
I was so happy to see Joey again.
I wanted to pull up the spear gun and just gun him down.
This is when Joey just gets hit with a big wave and bonks his head on some coral and dies.
Dies.
Yep. I would have been happy with that.
Jesus.
It should have gotten you like everyone else. Through
Max,
the ass.
Max is not pleased that he survived.
No, no, I am not.
Don't worry, we're Team Joey.
I feel like John Leguizamo could have also been cast for this role.
Probably.
Is The Pest on the list? I can't remember, because The Pest should be on the list.
The Pest will go on the list.
Yes!
They're really dry for just getting him out of the water right now, by the way.
Right.
Yeah. I will admit, I love how this movie ended.
Yeah.
Because like when they're like, oh yeah, an island in the middle of the ocean. I'm like, oh yeah, probably like some cultists of Dagon or Cthulhu on that island. And I love the pan out, the creature going through the
big
jungle.
Big volcano in the background.
Volcano in the background.
Yeah.
Great. Just absolutely great. I could know
now,
now
what?
Oh, Steven Sommers.
You just got to hit that last note on now what. That's yeah. We should have, one of us, we failed. One of us should have counted now what's in this movie.
Right. I think it's four or five.
Okay.
Okay.
But well, I didn't.
That's probably about right.
Yeah.
All right. Well, that's another episode of Good Brews, Bad Views. As always, please follow us on Twitter at GBBV Podcast or check us out on Facebook at Good Brews, Bad Views. Come back next time where we're going to be watching the Batman movie that the 90s forgot about, Batman Forever. So catch you guys later. As always, please drink and watch responsibly.